What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So we gotta check out this video that The Rock dropped on his Instagram page addressing Cody Rhodes. This should be very interesting. I'm looking to see what The Rock has to say. Some of you guys were tagging me on Twitter about this whole situation, so I'm very interested to see what The Rock has to say about Cody Rhodes and this whole situation on his Instagram page. Should be a good one. We're gonna go ahead and pull this up. I'm ready for this one, man. Let's get right into this. Switch it up and let's see what The Rock has to say about Cody Rhodes on his latest Instagram video.
It has been a big week. It's been a big week in the world of professional wrestling. It has been a big week in the world of the WWE. It has been a big week in the world of The Rock, in the world of the People's Champion, in the world of the Great One, and in the world of the most electrifying man walking God's green earth, Daddy. It has been that kind of week. And to quote the legend, one of The Rock's heroes, what's causing all of this?
And I think the reason why he went through all his little catchphrases, because I believe I seen something on Twitter yesterday or day before yesterday that The Rock now has the rights to all those sayings. Like, he actually owns the rights to all those sayings. I think before he didn't. I think Vince and, you know, WWE had the rights to those sayings. Now he actually owns the rights to his favorite catch lines. Like, he actually owns the rights to them, which is a very big deal for a wrestler to own his own catchphrases that damn near made him the most money in his career, you know, kind of put him on the map. So it's funny that he said that. This is getting very interesting.
Woo. It's been that kind of exciting week. Pro wrestling is exciting once again. It's been decades. Pro wrestling is cool once again.
Damn.
Pro wrestling is undeniably exciting once again. It's unpredictable. It's disruptive.
Yeah.
Because of one man, and that is The Rock.
Damn.
The Rock came back to pro wrestling, a business that The Rock loves, an industry that The Rock was born into, took professional wrestling, turned it on its head, disrupted the shit out of it, and it will never ever be the same again.
Ooh, he got it.
And it feels good.
It feels good.
So damn good.
Yo.
You like The Rock or you don't like The Rock, it doesn't matter. Because it feels good.
It feels good.
Pro wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
It's back on time.
He's not lying, bro. Right now, wrestling, it's been on an uptick in like popularity for quite some time. Don't get it twisted. But right now, this is some stuff right here. What they got going on with this main event for WrestleMania, this is definitely giving me Attitude Era vibes of what's going to happen. You got to watch each and every week just to see what's going to happen with this main event storyline, bro. They are cooking right now. They are cooking, and I love it. That's a cool visual.
It feels good. It feels good. But you know what? You know what? Here's the thing. You know what doesn't feel good? Well, The Rock will tell you what doesn't feel good.
Uh-oh.
What doesn't feel good is all the bullshit
that The Rock
has got to deal with. All the bullshit that the People's Champion has got to deal with. All the Cody crybabies.
Here we go.
Still running their mouths.
Oh.
All the jabronis in the locker room still running their mealy mouths. That The Rock still got to deal with. Cody crybabies. Take a look.
You know who is my favorite right now? It's Cody Rhodes. Do you know who I hate and I fucking despise?
Oh my God!
Dwayne Johnson, member of the board of directors of TKO. I hate that man right now in this moment. Not as a person,
right now,
obviously, but as a wrestling fan watching the product. The person I want to boo, the person I hate the most, is Dwayne Johnson, board of directors of the WWE and TKO. That's who I am angry at right now. Because I am looking at the board of director, that came in, used his power to take this opportunity away from Cody and put himself in the main event at WrestleMania 40. That's how I look at it right now.
So you see,
this is good, bro. This is good. They're bringing actual podcasts for this. Shout out to the Busted Open podcast, man. Appreciate y'all for having us on. That's cool. He used that in a clip as one of the Cody crybabies. This is cooking. This is cooking.
This is the level of absurdity and bullshit
that
The Rock has got to deal with. The Rock doesn't know who that guy is, but he knows what he is, and that's a goof.
An idiot.
Another pro wrestling Cody crybaby jack off
idiot. Oh my god!
But doesn't know shit.
Oh my god!
The guy is sitting in his basement
with
a bathrobe
and
a Cody Rhodes t-shirt on. And he's talking about how much he hates The Rock. You don't give that guy a podcast, you give him a straight jacket.
Oh!
He hates The Rock. It has nothing to do.
This is good.
The Rock will get to that in a second. It has everything to do with common sense, you idiot, you goof, and to all the Cody crybabies who are grown-ass men who think you know it all when you don't know shit. You listen up to The Rock right now. It has nothing to do with the board. It has nothing to do with the fact that The Rock owns everything as it relates to The Rock, the people's champion, full ownership, which means The Rock is the boss. It has nothing to do with that. It has to do with common sense.
This is good.
Let The Rock drop some gospel on you. Here's the common sense. When Roman Reigns, years ago, dropped the words, head of the table, those words were specifically and solely set up and created so one day Roman Reigns, the champion of the WWE, would come face to face with his cousin, The Rock, the people's champion, and together, combined, they will make the biggest WrestleMania of all time.
Which is definitely going to happen, y'all. It's going to happen. Don't get it twisted. This is not done. Once again, they called an audible. That's all it is. That's all it is. They called an audible. And they're turning it into a great storyline. That's all it is. Called an audible. That's it. People want to see the match. But obviously, Cody went in the Royal Rumble. It's one of those type of things where it's like, what's going to happen with that first? So, this match is definitely going to be must-see. I think it's going to even be a bigger match to see, depending on how things play out this year at WrestleMania, man.
The biggest match of all time. The biggest match in the history of professional wrestling. When Roman Reigns said those words, that's why he said it. Because that is Roman Reigns' story. That is The Rock's story. At one time, that was Cody Rhodes' story, but it was last year. And what happened last year at WrestleMania? What's the technical term? He shit the bed.
But we're just gonna ignore the fact that, you know, Solo and his dusty ass hoodie wasn't involved. Okay. Bro, this is so good. This is good, bro.
That's what happened. And then The Rock comes back on January 1st of this year. It's a big year. You know it, and The Rock knows it. It's an exciting year. You can feel it in the air. You can feel the mana. 2024, we're going to kick it off the right way. The Rock goes out there in front of that crowd in San Diego, California.
Uh-huh.
And said exactly what he promised he was going to say, because we had an agreement. And that agreement was The Rock was going to go out there and he was going to test the waters. And he was going to see how the crowd reacted. Where should The Rock sit?
Uh-huh.
You remember.
This was a good one.
Should The Rock sit at a booth? Crowd didn't know where I was going. Should The Rock sit
at a bar? Mm-hmm.
Oh, bigger reaction. Yeah, The Rock loves the bar because The Rock loves him some tequila.
Tequila.
Or should The Rock sit at the head of the table?
And that was such a cool moment. Not even going to hold you. That was like, okay, we're here. People was on board. Don't get it twisted. We're here. The question is how we was going to get there. And things change. Once Cody won the Royal Rumble, things changed. People was like, okay, hold on. Wait a minute. That's what happened. That's literally what happened.
Crowd that night exploded. Around the world exploded.
Goosebumps.
Just as sure as The Rock has chills on his arm.
This is good,
the
bro.
The world exploded.
This is so fucking good.
After all these years, they were finally getting The Rock versus Roman Reigns, the biggest WrestleMania of all time. And what happens? Cody Rhodes, he wins the Royal Rumble. Fair and square, works his ass off, and he wins that Royal Rumble, baby. Yeah, he's going to WrestleMania. Yeah, good for him.
Oh, this
the Rock
is,
was happy.
This was what good.
The Rock called Cody Rhodes.
Okay.
Had a conversation.
Yeah.
But it was a conversation that a few have had with Cody Rhodes before. Because Cody knew the biggest match of all time was looming. The Rock talked to Cody and said, Cody, you know, you love this business. The Rock loves this business. You were born into this business. The Rock was born into this business. Roman Reigns was born into this business. The three of us born into this business. You know, Cody, you got the biggest WrestleMania main event of all time. Right here, you have an opportunity to bring this business up to places it's never been before. You can always, with all due respect, finish your story another time.
Oh.
You agreed.
Oh. And here we go, which we kind of expected. He gave up his spot. Some were speculating that he's working with The Rock, and that may be the case. I don't know still. I doubt it from what they've been telling the story, but The Rock called him. He gave up his spot to face Roman once again. That's what it was initially. So unless Cody has something else to say on SmackDown talking about this, The Rock basically said, yeah, you gave up your spot to me, bro, because you knew this was the bigger match. And then you changed your mind.
This is good, bro.
Rocket stings, but I agree.
Damn!
It stings, but I'm a team player.
Oh!
I want what's best for the business.
Oh!
Good man. And then what happened? In Birmingham, Alabama, a city we selected because of history, and we knew we were going to make history. It was your job, Cody, to introduce The Rock, thus setting up the biggest main event of all time. And what'd you do? You did exactly what we agreed on. Brother, you introduced The Rock, and that place went crazy. And The Rock came out, and he dapped you up, he pulled you in and gave you a big hug, and I whispered something in your ear. Let's put on the biggest WrestleMania of all time. Let's do it for the American dream.
Oh.
Let's do it for the Soul Man.
Oh. This is getting good.
And I gave you a hug. You hugged The Rock back. And what'd you do, Cody? You walked out of that ring on live TV. And you turned back and you looked at The Rock. And instead of looking at The Rock saying, yeah, go get him. Let's make history. Instead of that, what'd you do? You gave The Rock a look. And it's the same look you gave the world. Like The Rock went out and ran over your goofy ass dog.
Oh! Oh, they are cooking. He is cooking. Oh my God. He is cooking. That they're turning a situation that the online fandom instantly rejected, and they're turning this into one of the greatest angles ever. This is one of the greatest audibles ever. They have turned it around. They're playing this up like Cody flip-flopped, which per storyline he did, but it's really because the crowd, the fans turned. Oh my, this is great.
That's the look you gave. Like The Rock ran over your goofy ass dog.
Oh, this is getting, don't talk about man's dog, bro. This is fantastic.
And then sometime from that moment on until Las Vegas, you changed your mind.
Oh, this is good.
You know what? That's no problem. You can change your mind. You have that right. And The Rock accepts that. Everybody has a right to change their mind. The Rock accepts it. You changed your mind. But here's what The Rock doesn't accept.
Uh-oh.
Is how you did it. I'll say it again, because it's important. To all the Cody crybabies and all the goofs out there and the idiots who still complain. Cody, you had a right to change your mind. You won the Royal Rumble. But what The Rock doesn't accept is how you did it. Saw you in Las Vegas. Saw you in Las Vegas. Saw you backstage 20 feet away. Rock dapped you up, gave you a hug.
Oh!
Didn't say anything to The Rock then.
Hey, oh!
I got something on my mind. Yeah, tell me about it. Hey, Rock, I got something that's eating me up inside. Cody, go ahead. Tell me about it. Let's walk over there. Let's talk in private. Come and tell me about it. Did you say any of that? No, you didn't say a thing. But what'd you do? You waited until Roman Reigns walked out there and announced he's facing The Rock.
Oh.
Then The Rock went out there and showed the entire family tree.
This is so good.
Of the most dominant family.
This is so good.
Professional wrestling, in entertainment, and in sports in the world. And accepted Roman Reigns. Accepted the challenge. Blood oath. And we were going to put on the biggest WrestleMania of all time. What'd you do? Then you came out and you interrupted.
Hold on.
Yeah. Yup. This right here is bullshit. Yes. Yeah. I'm here for it.
Yeah, it was bullshit.
You this is great.
Bullshit, brother. Not
this
a
is,
problem.
This is great, bro.
But you know where you really screwed up?
Yep, here we go.
It's when you talk shit about my family. All the Cody crybabies. No, he didn't. No, he didn't. Shut your mouths. You what'd you call him, Cody?
It's not a family. They are nothing but lackeys, but yes men. They're goons.
Then you spoke about Roman's grandfather, and you spoke about my grandfather, the great.
Even though we're just gonna ignore the fact that Roman brought up his family and had been disrespected by Roman himself. Cody been disrespected. He brought up his father again, but we're gonna ignore that fact. This is why it's good.
Hi, Chief Peter Maivia.
If your grandfather was here, if the High Chief, his grandfather was here, they'd be ashamed of you.
Here we go.
I did to you, Cody Rhodes, in that moment what I would do to you a million times, which is slap the taste right out of your mouth.
Cody, you gotta fight back.
And then what happened? The Rock embarrassed you in front of the world, boy. Slapped the shit out of you. You had it coming. Talk shit about my family again. Said it to you then, I'll say it again. I'll say it forever. Talk shit about my family again, and I'll do worse than that. But then what happened? Your new best friend. You got a new best friend. How about that? You got a new best friend in the walking clown show known as Seth Rollins. What did Seth do? The Rock slaps the shit out of you. Seth steps to The Rock.
This is good.
Rock pushed him back, gave him a little love tap. Get back. You don't want any of this. The Rock doesn't know you. You don't know The Rock, but you don't want to know The Rock in that way. This is none of your business. The Rock doesn't know Seth Rollins, never said a word about Seth Rollins publicly, privately, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. The Rock has no idea. The Rock has no idea why this man is getting in our business, but he did. And not only that, but then he just can't help himself. Like a lot of the jabronis in the locker room just can't help himself and start talking shit about The Rock. Take a look.
Yeah, he's going to open his mouth. He's going to run his mouth. He's going to say the same crap he's been saying for the last two decades.
They're setting this up.
They're setting this up. But the bottom line is, and I've said it before, he's an afterthought. This is our story. It's our era. We built the last decade of WWE, this Elimination Chamber show, WrestleMania, the biggest ever. We built it without him.
So he can come in, he can get what he wants, he can take a little piece, and then he can go back to Hollywood and do his thing. Because we got this thing, but we don't need you, big guy.
Oh, my God.
This is
you
good.
You don't need The Rock, huh?
Uh-oh.
Rock, we don't need you. You don't need The Rock. If you were a little smarter, Seth, you'd realize how stupid you sound. Let The Rock drop some gospel on your goofy ass. You need The Rock in ways that you can't even imagine.
Oh.
Here's some gospel. You think when Ari Emanuel,
uh-oh,
The Rock's good friend, The Rock's business partner for decades, The Rock's lead agent, someone who The Rock looks to like a big brother, you think when he goes to sit with Netflix, across from Ted Sarandos, The Rock's good buddy and business partner, sitting across from Bella Bajaria, The Rock's good friend and business partner at Netflix, you think when they're inking, when they're signing this $5 billion deal
for the WWE
and Netflix, do you think that Ted and Bella is saying, hey, Ari, when WWE comes to Netflix, is Seth Rollins going to be champion? Do you think that that's what they're asking?
Oh, my.
No, they're not asking that, number one, because they don't care, and number two, they don't know who in the hell you are. You know what they're asking? Hey, Ari, we'll sign this $5 billion historical deal. Never before. But one question. Where's the people's champion? One question. Where is the man, The Rock himself? One question. Where's the man who has the most watched film in the history of Netflix, The Rock? Where is he at in this whole thing?
Damn.
Ari looks at them and says, he's locked in for life. He's locked in for life. Director of the board, owns everything as it relates to his name.
Yeah.
He's locked in for life. Signed $5 billion. So Seth Rollins, you understand now how much you need The Rock? Uh-huh. You understand now, right, boy?
Oh.
And you keep running your mouth. You keep running your mouth, Rock. You find some new material, Rock. Find some new material. Is that right? Okay, well, The Rock has some new material for you. How about this? Here's some new material for you, Seth Rollins. How about this? The Rock sits at the top. Director, TKO board. Not WWE, but TKO. Which means The Rock is the boss. Which means The Rock is your boss.
Oh.
Which means The Rock owns everything. The Rock, everything associated with The Rock, the people's champion, owns it all. Which means The Rock is your boss. Which means, Seth Rollins, if you keep running your mouth and sticking your nose in the Bloodline's business,
uh-oh,
and that world title that
uh-oh
you have around your waist, very soon, The Rock will make that title go to somebody else.
Oh! Oh!
Read between the lines. Yes, The Rock just blurred it. Keep running your mouth, sticking your nose in the Bloodline's business. This is between The Rock and it is between Roman Reigns and Cody Rhodes. That's it. Stick your nose where it doesn't belong. The Rock guarantees you. And The Rock has built a career on doing everything he has said he's going to do. The Rock guarantees you stick your nose in our business, that world title that you have around your waist will go to somebody else.
Oh.
It will go to somebody else. And there's two things you could do about it, Seth. Nothing in like it. You keep sticking your nose in our business, The Rock and Roman Reigns are going to beat your goofy ass right back to the circus with the rest of the clowns.
This is great. This is fantastic.
Cody Rhodes.
This is fantastic, bro.
For you, the Cody crybabies. For your new best friend, the walking clown emoji himself, Seth Rollins. And to your goofy ass dog.
Oh!
The says this. You all are advocates of Cody finishing his story. It's so important. Cody Rhodes, you took something from The Rock. You insulted my family. You took something from The Rock. You took something from Roman Reigns. You took something from the millions and millions and millions and millions of the real fans who wanted to see the biggest WrestleMania event of all time. You took it away.
This is so good. This is fantastic.
Now you're going to pay. Cody Rhodes, from the bottom of my heart, man to man, fuck your story.
Oh, oh my God! Oh my God!
Glendale, Arizona. Greatness is coming. Friday Night Live. SmackDown. Dallas, Texas. Greatness is coming. You are on deck. March 8th. Greatness is coming. Memphis, Tennessee. March 15th. The Rock is coming home. With The Rock. It's cooking. Fuck your story. Wins that Royal Rumble, baby. Yeah. He's going to WrestleMania. Yeah.
Oh my God, bro. I don't even know what to say, bro. Cody, tonight on SmackDown, I'm filming this on Friday. Cody, you have to say something now. He's being very disrespectful. Cody, it's time to turn it up. There's no more talking unless you want some very disrespectful stuff. It's time to turn it up. It's time to turn it up. Seth, it's time to turn it up. We here now. Nigga said, fuck you, the clown Seth Rollins, and your dog. Fuck your story. This is great. This is the Rock we need. This is the Rock we love. This right here. And I'm glad he did this on Instagram, because obviously doing this on WWE television, they're going to cut out some things, all this other stuff. You know, that was fantastic. Oh, tonight on SmackDown is must watch once again, because Cody, you got to say something. It's time. You no holds barred. Let it be known. Let it all out. Oh yeah, this match between The Rock and Cody. Oh yeah, I'm here for it now. Oh my God, this was great. This was fucking great. Nigga said, "Fuck your story. I'm done." Comment down below. Let me know, man, what y'all thought of this whole promo, 20-minute promo from The Rock. Let me know, bro. This was fantastic. This was great. Let me know if you guys are excited even more for SmackDown tonight and what's going to happen at this year's WrestleMania. This was great. This was fucking fantastic. I appreciate all love and support. Brought to 150K, and I'm still your undisputed YouTube wrestling champ of the world. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all next one. Peace.